My name is Steve Barnes, and I would like very much to welcome you to the fourth Costume Con and the Science Fiction Fantasy Costume Competition thereof. I'd like to introduce our judges, Laurie McDonald. Okay, Jennifer Tippett, another talented costumer. And Philip Mercier, a master costumer. Costume number one, worn by Angelique Trouvert and Fabian X in the artisan division. Costume title is Here Comes the Bride.
Weekly radio spotlight on the doings and the undoings in the underworld. Today, the East Coast Lawak proudly announces the imminent marriage of his beloved godchild, Baby, of East Coast Bimbo family, you know what I mean, your husbands, to the duly appointed leader of the cosmos, the one, the only, the fabulous Godfuzzy. Maybe due to the fact that Baby has been subpoenaed to appear before a grand jury hearing shortly after the ceremony. Or maybe, could this be a Tommy Gunn wedding? The furry figurehead insists that there is no, I repeat, no Fuzzy in the oven. And that this is simply a case of true love, as demonstrated by a modest token of affection given to his beloved fiancée. Aw, oh, come on, honey, show us the ring. Yeah, the ring. Yeah, who says crime don't pay? Anywho, we wish much luck to the happy couple in the coming years. We're gonna need
entry number two is made and worn by Marge Ehlers. It is in the master division. And the costume is Father Guido Sarducci from Saturday Night Live. Famed gossip columnist for the Osservatore Romano, only member of his class, not already a Monsignor, but hoping for elevation soon. Founder of the 20-Minute University for teaching everyone whatever you can remember after you graduate about one sentence. Designed and worn by Mary Lepic. Costume title is Lady of the Green Kirtle, from C.S. Lewis's The Silver Chair. Although beautiful and innocent in appearance, the Lady of the Green Kirtle had the fatal sting of a serpent hidden beneath her charms. She used these powers to enslave Prince Rillian, but disguised as a snake, she murdered his mother, the Queen of Narnia. Designed and worn by Ricky and Myla Dick. Costume title, Flim and Smegma Fugly.
Aren't they lovely? to the lost cures.
You didn't need to give them a hand. They already had one. Thank you. Entry number 5 in the novice class. Designed by Karen Kuykendall, Nancy Floyd, and Linda Whitten. Made and worn by Nancy Floyd and Linda Whitten. It's Pentacles. Based on Tarot of the Cat People by Karen Kuykendall. There is no number 6. We'll go straight to number 7. Any prisoner fans out there? I knew that. In the Journeyman class, designed and made by Julia Ann Hill. Costume title, Supreme Astrologer from Planet Druzba.
Seeks to find the star to guide the High Priestess through the eons of time.
Designed, made, and worn by Jacqueline Ward, the Wicked Fairy Carabosse from the ballet Sleeping Beauty. Carabosse, the wicked fairy from the ballet Sleeping Beauty, the king and queen, overjoyed at the birth of their daughter Aurora, held a great banquet for her christening, but they forgot to invite the fairy Carabosse. Enraged, she burst in on their festivities and cursed the baby princess, decreeing that on her 16th birthday, Aurora would prick her finger on a spindle and die. Entry number 9 in the Journeyman class, designed by Deborah K. Jones and Jay Gruhl, made and worn by Deborah K. Jones, Winnie the Witch from Raggedy Ann and Andy and the Camel with Wrinkled Knees. Raggedy Ann and Andy and the Camel with Wrinkled Knees was published in 1924 by writer-illustrator Johnny Gruhl. The characters encounter fabulous Winnie the Witch, whose magic is transformation. Those who step into her magic circle emerge transformed into their true selves. Entry number 10, in the artisan class, designed and worn by Karen Kuykendall and made by Billy Lewis and Karen Kuykendall, we have a tribeswoman of the outer regions in festive dress. Number 11, in the novice class, we have a costume designed, made, and worn by Benita Reed, and its title is Moon Goddess. The only thing I don't like about this job is that I can't say anything about the costumes. Some of them are so nice. Entry number 12, designed, made, and worn by that triple threat, Terry Duquet. In the novice class, Marvel Comics, The New Spider-Man. Number 13, in the artisan category, designed and made by Ginny Ketchum and worn by Marty and Bobby Gear, we have the rose. Through the pages of history walks a lonely vampire and his one true love. From Chelsea Quinn Yarborough's The Palace, we present Rogazi Saint-Germain and Olivia. The rust velvet is hand silk screened in a design which incorporates Bob White's, Stone Martens, and Gears. Entry number 14. In the master class, designed, made, and worn by David Joyner, we have Warrior of the Dream Plane. Neither magic nor technology can maintain a constant strength across all dimensions. Thus, Talon, the Dream Warrior, has harnessed the power of life force, the universal soul stuff itself. As he travels the myriad shadow realities, his armor and weapons are living, sentient constructs, able to guide, to heal, and to grow. Entry number 15, in the artisan class, designed by Michael Whalen, made and worn by Paula Crist, we have Killassandra from Killassandra by Anne McCaffrey, a tribute to Anne McCaffrey and her cover artist, Michael Whalen. Number 16, in the novice class. Designed, made, and worn by Patty Cook, we have Ayesha. Her revival of the ancient dance forms is evocative of Mother Earth. This is much appreciated by the miners, traders, and soldiers after months of the stark harshness of small space vessels. Number 17, in the artisan class. Designed by Susan Tabanek and Julie Zetterberg, made and worn by the same. Costume title is Rosita and Rosita.
Rosita and Rosita. On a whirlwind tour of the planet, these exotic creatures will astound you as they fake the fancy fairy footwork, your favorites from Miami Vice, the Flamingo Dancers.
Number 18 in the masterclass. Designed, made, and worn by Animal X and Fabian X, with David Smith, Kevin Roche, and Garrett Rigoni.
Here
okay.
We have Kylara, fresh from a hard
costume title: Kylara of Pern
Lady
and Family.
Kylara, a vain, short-tempered, self-serving glamour queen. However, those of us who truly understand her know her to be not only a gentle, loving soul, but also a kind, warm, tender, doting, devoted mother.
Okay, this was the missing number 6. Actually follow it, yes. This is number 6. Okay. In the Journeyman class, designed by Amy Hartlove, made and worn by Amy Hartlove, the title is Lilith. demon whose special province it is to ensure that people enjoy themselves at parties and social gatherings. Number 19 in the Journeyman division, designed, made, and worn by Julia Hill, we have Envoy from the planet Druzba. On the planet Druzba, there evolved a race of beings that resembled a creature Earthlings called a cat.
The Taro of the cat people.
A secret envoy was sent, but in spite of the language translator in the headdress and the high rank of the envoy indicated by the collar, they were unable to establish contact and left Earth. Entry number 20, Journeyman class. Designed, made, and worn by G. Robert Meyer. From a design interpreted by Bonnie Bashore and G. Robert Meyer. High Priest and High Priestess.
The Taro of the Cat People. Inspired these costumes by G. Robert Meyer Jr. and Bonnie Bashore. Because of their interest in Taro and their shared love for cats, they chose to recreate these designs originally done by Karen Kuykendall for U.S. Game Systems Incorporate. The High Priestess and High Priest of the Major Arcana. From the outer regions, there is the kingdom of Vepala, the Sky People. Both the High Priestess and the High Priest are robed in glitter chiffon, accented by sprays of color. The collars are applique work. Both Bonnie and Bob are modeling the creations. Thank you, Karen Kuykendall, for the inspiration.
Number 21, the Master Class. Designed by Bob Ringwood for the movie Dune. The beginning.
Very delicate time. Know then that it is the year 10,191. In this time, the most precious substance in the universe is the spice melange. The spice exists on only one planet in the entire universe. The planet is Arrakis, also known as Dune.
Thank you.
Cerulean. The introduction was by Diane Dora. Jessica was Karen Turner. Pauline Trades was Kelly Turner. Duke Leto was John Uden. Princess Irulan was Janet Wilson. Bene Gesserit was Julie Neff. Dr. Yue was Randy Neff. And Padishah Emperor Shaddan IV, Gary Anderson. And our last entry for the evening, designed by Victoria Reidner and Adrian Butterfield, made by Adrian Butterfield and worn by Adrian Butterfield. The costume title is Beauty and the Beast. This is not in competition. We present the winners of Best in Show at WesterCon 1980, Adrian Butterfield and Victoria Reidner as Beauty and the Beast. Hand just for everybody who's competing up here today. Okay. There will be a short break while the judges make their determinations. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Very friendly.
Snack.
Snack.
Snack, yes.
Oh, for later.
Mm. Yeah. My name is Mary, and I think the costume is Lady of the Green Curlets from the C.S. Lewis Narnia books. I start off being a very nice person, I turn into a snake.
Almost all of these people got it right from beginning to end. It wasn't just a neat mask or a neat piece of sewing or a neat accessory. The whole bloody thing went together.
Well, as Drew said when he came to lead us up, you know, it's, you know, as opposed to the usual convention, instead of having lots of skim milk and a little bit of cream, it was lots of cream and a little bit of skim milk.
Welcome back. And we're ready to announce the winners. Jennifer Tift will be making that announcement. Jennifer, please.
Well, as you could all see for yourselves, it was certainly a night of very, very stiff competition. So we decided to be generous. It needed to be done. Starting with the novice division, the best recreation in novice goes to Terry Duquette as the new Spider-Man. There's the name. Most beautiful in the novice division
goes to Benita Reed as the moon goddess. And the Best Workmanship Award in Novice goes to Nancy Floyd and Linda Whitten as Pentacles. In the Journeyman division, an honorable mention goes to Julia Hill with Envoy from the Planet Dresba. Most Beautiful Journeyman is awarded to Mary Lepic for The Lady of the Green Kirtle. For Best Fantasy in Journeyman, we have Amy Hartlove, Lilith. In the Artisan category division, we have an honorable mention for Rosita and Rosita. Made and worn by Susan Tobinek and Julia Zetterberg. For Best Interpretation in the Artisan division, we have Paula Crist as Kilchandra. Most Humorous in the Artisan division goes to Ricky and Myla Dick as Flam and Smegma. Most Striking in the Artisan division goes to Jacqueline Ward as the Wicked Fairy Carabas. And finally, Best Presentation in the Artisan division with a special award for the most sensuous kissing of a lady's hand goes to Marty and Bobby Gear, the Rhodes. In the Master division, we have an honorable mention for Kailara of Pern, played by Animal X, Favian X, David Smith, Kevin Roach, and Garrett Ragone. Most Divine is given to Margie Ellers for Father Guido Sarducci. Yay! Best Science Fiction and Award for Technical Excellence goes to David Joyner, Warrior of the Green Flame. Show Recreation is given to Winnie the Witch, Deborah K. Jones. Deborah is a journeyman, by the way. And best in show is given to Doom, the beginning. One just absolutely outstanding costume in the audience. This, the award from the present chairman to the best future chairman. And the past chairman also concurs. I'm now going to turn you back over to Steve Barnes for the final remarks. Thank you very much.
And that is the conclusion of the Science Fiction Fantasy Costuming Awards and presentations for this year. I'd like very much to thank the technical crew, both sound and lights, who helped make this possible. And the construction people and all those good folks, and a lot to you out there, have been very, very responsive and very understanding during some of the glitches this evening. So thank you very much, good night, and have a good time at the parties.